तुम्ही जिकडे भागलो एक मिनिट या
goes way back to Maryland, early 90s. But even before that, in 1983, we had Narasimha Rao as the External Affairs Minister, and Madam Indira Gandhi was the Prime Minister. She was in New York in 83, and she was supposed to come here. But she could not come, so she sent Narasimha Rao, who's a good friend of our Narendra Reddy. So Narasimha Rao came here. That is the time when we connected with the King family. So Martin Luther King had already passed away. So that is the time we connected with the King family. Coretta Scott King is late wife. So she was very keen to outreach with the community. So she helped us a lot. So in 87, she gave us a room, Gandhi Room. It's in that building back there, it's called Freedom Hall. So they gave us a room, which was a mighty nice of, on her part. So we had created a Gandhi Room. And all the materials and memorabilia was presented to us by Ambassador Pratapkrishna Kaur, P.K. Kaur. He was the ambassador at that time. So 87, we inaugurated Gandhi Room. Now at that time, National Federation, the national organization, was not very active. But the local organization, Indian American Cultural Association, that was it. And I was the president of that organization at that. So anyway, we worked on it and we created a Gandhi Room out there. Now there are only three rooms there. One is Gandhi Room, other is King's own room, husband and wife, and the third is Rosa Parks room. Rosa Parks was the one who challenged the bus discrimination from Alabama. So we have those three rooms there, but because of COVID and all that, it's not open. There was, out here there was a big hill.
Okay.
This building did not exist. Okay. Okay, all this was not, on the other side of the road is the King Administration Building. Behind that is the Freedom Hall. And on this side is Ebenezer Baptist Church, which we must take pictures going there. So now that is where happening. In 92, we thought we would do something for Gandhi. National Federation of Indian American Association, NFI. Mm. So we said this National Federation should do something. So we said we want a Gandhi Street. So the birth home of Dr. King.
Just draws all from different walks of life.
Mrs. Pallavi Joshi, she has acted as Gandhi's wife.
Kasturba Gandhi.
Kasturba Gandhi in a movie.
Oh, really?
The Mahatma.
You mean the big, with Ben Kinsey?
Not with Ben.
And she was very critical of her husband.
and we have a very
so, wonderful.
Connection. Yes.
I'm honored.
And not only that, his parents are very serious Gandhi followers in India. Oh. And he was also very involved with the Gandhi ground.
Both my parents worked with Gandhi, you know.
Really?
Yeah, they were in jail with Gandhi, you know. Oh.
Yeah. And we have added one more dimension today. India's constitution, Dr. follower of Gandhi. So today is an Indian Constitution Day, so we have combined that.
Oh,
so that's what you're seeing. He was the one.
He wrote our constitution, the Indian really, constitution.
Yeah.
And Mallika, move around wherever you want. You are the main photographer. She's a professional one.
Actually, we'll take pictures after we do the garland.
No, but she's
doing that. No.
So don't hesitate.
Hey, I'm going to
go. Thanks.
Sir.
Yeah. morning, everyone. It's my great Martin Luther King National Historic Site. I would like to extend a warm welcome to Mr. Vivek Rajan Agnihotri, a renowned film director, producer, and screenwriter in India. Sir, welcome to you. Now I would like to welcome Mrs. Pallavi Joshi, a celebrated actress in India. She worked in many films and television series in Hindi and multiple regional languages. She won many prestigious national film awards. Madam, welcome to you.
Thank you so much.
Our special welcome to Honorable Dr. Swati Kulkarni, the Consul General of India, and Mr. Kulkarni, and all the staff, all the officers of the Consulate of India. Welcome to you all. And last but not least, welcome to all of you gathered here. And you are always supporting Gandhi Foundation. Thank you.
It's a great pleasure. And we always pay our homage and respect to Gandhiji through our own humble way. And that is by garlanding. The first one who always leads the garlanding is our Consul General Swati. So that's our ritual. So would you please add that?
I would just like to say it's a great honor to be garlanding the father of humanity, to meet the greatest peace lover of the second half of the last century, Nelson Mandela. And the only wish that was remaining was that I come to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s crypt. And today, again, thanks to the Father of our Nation.
Okay.
Look this way and touch his feet.
The opportunity. Jai Ho Gandhi. Jai Ho Gandhi Ji. Jai Ho Gandhi Ji.
And you also. The first time. Okay. All right. That's for you.
बोलू सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल
एंड राज
आई लव दिस
चलिए नाउ यू हैव द फ्लोर
So good morning everyone on this cloudy, drizzling morning. Honorable Consul General Swati Ji, Rajdan Sahab, Anthony Ji, Surinder Ji, all my friends here, thanks for inviting us here. I just want to tell all of you a little secret why it is so important for me. A problem these days is that everything has become a spectacle. Unless something is spectacular, we don't think that anything has happened. But I want to share a little secret. The first book I ever read was Gandhi's autobiography, My Experiments with Truth. Both my parents were Gandhians. They worked with Gandhi very closely. My father worked very closely with Gandhi. Both my parents were freedom fighters. They went to jail. My father was at the same time when Gandhi was there. And so I grew up in a Gandhian family where both my parents wore khadi till the last breath they took. I started my professional career of this oratory and speeches you hear. Actually, it all started with Gandhi elocution competitions in Sevagram and Sabarmati. My first 1,000 rupees I earned by winning Gandhi speech, Gandhi memorial speech. It was sponsored by Ramakrishna Jamnalal Bajaj. And with that money, I did my post-graduation. Whatever money I had earned, I never took even one penny from my parents. And whatever education I did was from that. So for me, it's a very important day. And Pallavi played Kasturba in making of the Mahatma. And she spent long time of her prime youth studying Gandhi, isn't it? And so it's very important. Today, the problem is that, I'm sorry for saying this, but the problem is that all kind of crooks use Gandhi's name, and that's why Gandhi is not, in India especially, has the place, the kind of place it deserves. He indeed was one of the greatest souls ever born on this earth. And I know when the history will be just many, many thousand years later, his name will be in the same class and category as Buddha or Mahavir or Guru Nanak. Because when he came to India, I was recently reading Vivekananda. I'm reading Vivekananda a lot these days for my research. And Sri Aurobindo, these two people I'm reading. When Gandhi came to India from South Africa, that time society was so fragmented and conflicted, which nobody in history teaches us. Nobody tells us when he came how conflicted Hindu society was amongst itself. And Gandhi, with his great symbolism and sacrifice, he united everybody, inspired everybody, and he understood that the violence cannot be the means to find freedom. Even if he had found freedom, it would have been a bloody violent freedom. So he united India. My only regret is that after independence, we did not follow Gandhi's economic model. I still believe that if India follows Gandhi's economic model of Swaraj, I think that definitely will change, because so much of disparity in this world is happening because there are hardly any Gandhis, and Gandhi is used only for political. And so thanks for inviting me here. I cannot be more humbled. We are walking to Martin Luther King Jr.'s memorial after this. Again, a great ambassador of peace. And today is also a very special day, because today is the death anniversary of the father of our constitution, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar ji. So thanks for being here. Thanks for inviting me.
Honorable Council General,
louder.
Razdan ji, Sarita ji, and all the others here. It's a great honor for both me and Vivek to be here. As Vivek has already spoken, we have been ardent followers of Gandhi, not just in my personal life, but for my professional reasons also. I had to study both Gandhiji and his wife Kasturba in detail for the film that Mr. Shyam Benegal made. When I went to South Africa, I had the honor to go to the same station of Pietermaritzburg where Gandhiji was thrown out of the train carriage. And we, although I was not shooting that day, but I still went to the station to pay homage to that side. We went to Durban where he fought many court cases against the South Africans during the apartheid. And it's a great day for all of us to be here. Dr. King believed in the same principles of non-violence and peace. I couldn't have imagined that during the Kashmir Files roadshow, there could ever be a day where we would, you know, get a chance to bow down to these great people who have propagated peace in this world. But that's what we are also doing through our film. We want to put an end to terrorism and propagate peace for all humankind. And it's a great coincidence that this wonderful day dawned on us today. So I wish you all a great and happy 6th of December, which is celebrated as the Constitution Day in India. We have the blessings of Gandhiji with us. We have the blessings of Dr. King. We have the blessings of Ambedkar Ji. We are all working towards peace. The entire Kashmiri Pandit community has always only propagated peace and peace for the entire world. So may peace remain, and may all humans again learn to love each other without discriminating caste, color, religion, anything else. That's all I wish on this day.
All lives matter.
I have to redeem myself, so if you could please come up here. No, please. And I have no. I mean, that will make us rich. And I request.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so. All of you have seen the movie. Some of you have seen the movie yesterday, The Kashmir Files. Yeah. Okay, so yesterday you saw the movie The Kashmir Files. And the film is based on the genocide of Kashmiri Pandits in 1990. Nobody had made this on this subject any film before this. But I just want to tell you why we are in USA before even the film has released in India. Because the theme of the film is right to justice, and we believe that in a democracy the most fundamental pillar is justice, and the Kashmiri Pandits haven't got justice, and we thought this film can become the soft power, and this film can enlighten people outside India to understand how so many thousands of people, hundreds of thousands of people, were forced to not just leave their home, but they were killed. Why does it happen? It happens because there are some evil people who do not understand the value of humanity. And that's why with this film we try to show the world what it means not to be human. Because ultimately, using humanity for political purpose is one thing, but being a human where you understand the concept of oneness. And this concept of oneness was given to this entire world by nothing else than Shaivism, the Shiva's philosophy. And the greatest Nobel Prize winning physicists have also acknowledged this concept of oneness of the cosmos. And I always say, and let me repeat it again, when Maharshi Ramana was asked by a BBC correspondent how to treat others, he repeated what Shiva's philosophy is. He said, there are no others. And that's exactly what Gandhi followed and propagated, and he preached to the world. And I think standing by Gandhi's or Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s principles, if we follow these principles that there are no others in this world, everybody is the same, that is justice. Nothing else is justice. And this tour is about right to justice.
Oh, wonderful.
My warm greetings to all of you, Mr. Agnihotri, Ms. Panamiji, Rajdan Saab, as always, Mr. Dhar, our Narendra Bhai, Mrs. Raj, and all our dignitaries here. It's, you know, on this winter, in this windy day, you are here. We are so happy that in Atlanta, usually the weather is good. But now we are seeing this wind and little bit of cold. But you are here and you have energized everyone. The film yesterday was so powerful. Since yesterday, we are only talking about it. Nothing else is being discussed. We all are at home with others, with everybody I am meeting in office. We all are speaking about this movie. So today, we are happy that Rajdan Saab, you have kept them to see this legendary statue which we have here in the hallowed grounds. So good you have visited and seen how the Gandhi is revered in this part of the world, like people like Mani and everybody. How they revere it in the grounds where Dr. Martin Luther King is also. So today is another important day where we are celebrating 6th of December, Mahaparinirvan Divas, what we call the death anniversary of Dr. Ambedkar. So both, in fact, these three leaders, they are iconic leaders, Dr. Martin Luther King, Mahatma Gandhi and Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. And for us, Mahatma Gandhi and Dr. Ambedkar, they are iconic figures, they are national leaders. One is father of nation, one is father of constitution. So both worked relentlessly for the, you know, women, for having casteless society. And above all, they worked for hope, courage and freedom. So that's their philosophy, where we always talk about satyagraha and the non-violence. That's the cornerstone of it. And these extraordinary, inspirational forces which we have, and that's why our country is so great, and they are noble ideals. So let us reflect on what they have taught to us and what they have given to the society, and that's why it's become such a wonderful place to live. I have my special, when I was appearing for medical exams, I went for the Sevagram Medical College, and that time, first time I read Gandhian philosophy, because you have to give a paper on Gandhian philosophy before you pass out your medical. So I gave that paper, and then when I was in final MBBS, we went there for a pediatric quiz, because we won in our college and there was an inter-college competition. So first time I visited that college. So that's, I do have some of my fond memories related to Gandhi and his philosophy. And of course, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, I come from a land where Dikshabhoomi is one of the most historic part, where in Nagpur they have the celebration on 6th of December, which is a huge, huge celebration. And we as children, we have witnessed it over and over again. So thank you so much, and welcome again to Atlanta. We are cherishing every and each bit of your presence here. Thanks for giving this glorious moments to us. Thank you.
Almost a million tourists come. But before that, almost a million tourists come. This is how they come. They park their buses, cars, they come this way. And actually, if Marie looks into her files, you'll see this was called Gandhi Promenade. But then they said, hey, you're asking too much now. So they removed the word Gandhi and they call it a promenade. Okay. But if you see the original docs there, this was called Gandhi Promenade. But
Troilus immortal.
But the fact remains, we have got tremendous cooperation from National Park Service. And this is not just simple National Park, this is the U.S. Department of Interior. This is a federal government department. They have these National Park Service people, and they have been our greatest partners. So, a million tourists come, and what do they see first? The statue. The second most important thing is the partnership with the King Center. They have been tremendous partners. And as I said, I talked about Gandhi Room, but here also with the statue and all that. Then they created an eternal frame. They will go there. And that eternal frame, Chief Justice Balakrishnan, he did the inauguration. Not only that, I have some good news since you talked about Sevagram. Next time when you go back to India, I'd like you to visit Dindigul, the Gandhigram Rural University near Madurai. We have a Gandhian King Center in Dindigul, in Gandhigram Rural University. And it was, of course, Bernice King, the daughter, could not come there, but she gave us a virtual inauguration of it. So I urge you to visit that place, sure. And if you decide to go there, we'll arrange something. Okay. So we have a Gandhi and King Center, courtesy Mr. Dr. Bernice King. Okay. So there is a very good relationship going on here. Then on top of that, then we have, of course, the consulate, and she has walked an extra mile here, with us all along. So we thank you for your support and partnership. That today, as he talked about the movie, we thought the most befitting way to connect the whole event was to have a peace walk. And so therefore, we'll do a peace walk from the Gandhi statue to Dr. King's crypts, Samadhi. How can you better that? That is the best thing you can think of, the peace between the two. But while we go that way, we will cross the visitor center here, which is closed because of COVID. But then we'll cross Ebenezer Church, That's where Dr. King used to preach.
Okay.
And if we have time, we'll go and see Dr. King's birth hall. If not, for your next one.
But just in the car.
Just in the car. Yeah. Surinder, your car is there? So I'll lead you in the car. We'll just kind of show them. So with this, with madam,
yes,
please lead us.
This peace walk is for peace. Hopefully, all of us, the pundits, can go to our motherland to visit us. Take our children, our grandchildren. So this is happy.